Hi, thanks for clicking and joining me once again on Movies From A to Zoe. Today I'll be talking about the movie Moana.
The title character, Moana, voiced by Auli’i Cravalho, is about a young woman who goes on a quest to save her village and must find herself in the process. In her journey, she must seek out the demigod Maui, who's voiced by Dwayne Johnson, and return the stolen heart of Te Fiti, a Mother Earth goddess who created all of the islands from her heart. Now this is the time of year to start handing out awards, and I am ready to give Moana the Best Animated Feature Oscar. Disney managed to recapture their magic to create a beautiful story with fantastic characters and gorgeous music. And of course, the fact that Moana is a fabulous female role model doesn't really hurt either. This is a girl who's strong and brave and smart. She follows her heart. She stands up to her father and everyone else who tells her that the world beyond the shoreline is dangerous. Moana trusts that the ocean has chosen her to save her people and readily takes up the quest. Pay attention to just how often Moana is discouraged in her journey. Her father and Maui in particular, both in song and speech, tell her that the world is scary, that she's only a young girl, and that she needs to stop dreaming. Disney usually factors in a supportive sidekick, but this time Moana barely even had that. It was a silent cross-eyed chicken. When I studied film analysis, I remember discussing there were about 26 elements that Disney movies generally include. There's usually a dead or absent parent and misplaced trust in a key character. So it's interesting in watching Moana that Disney actually moved away from a lot of those characteristics, and neither of those particular ones are actually included in the film. It definitely had echoes of previous Disney movies though, and that makes sense because there were 4 credited directors, yes, four of them, whose credits include movies such as Aladdin, Tarzan, The Little Mermaid, Mulan, and Hercules under their collective writing and directing belts. There was an interesting scene that stood out to me about princesses, an entire genre of characters that Disney is known for more than any other. In the scene, Maui calls Moana a princess, a term that she insists has nothing to do with her, as being the chief's daughter is something different entirely. And that scene stood out to me as my least favorite in the movie because it completely writes off the ability and positive qualities of every other Disney princess that has been created, depicted, and well-loved over the years. Now, the very studio that gave us these characters is essentially telling us that they aren't worthy and that Moana is better than they are. While there are certainly feminist issues with the princess depiction, as a princess lover myself, I think it negates their good qualities. In some ways, this takes exactly what feminists hate about the Disney princesses and discounts what audiences have loved. I mean, why can't Moana be a princess? Is there some reason her qualities of strength, intelligence, and bravery aren't compatible with what is essentially just a designation of lineage? Now, I get that princess movies had a bad connotation, but as a longtime princess defender, I didn't love that Moana knocked them down too. I think Moana is what the Disney-loving public has been waiting for, though. It's a modern movie with a strong lead who doesn't have to apologize for going after her dreams and for trusting herself. Moana shows us that bravery, intelligence, and even beauty can go hand in hand. Now for some interesting eagle-eye details to watch for. Keep an eye out for all of the conch shells in the movie, particularly at the beginning and end. Now, conch shells have a strong presence in religion. It's one of Buddha's auspicious symbols and represents an awakening from ignorance. In Indian literature, nearly every god or goddess holds a conch shell when happy or when going to war. In Chinese Buddhism, it represents a prosperous journey, and even in Islam, it represents hearing within the divine world. Every single one of these applications applies to Moana and her interactions with the conch shells in the movie. Moana's strength and fortitude are symbolized by this shell, which is so closely tied to her at both the beginning and end of the film. Next, make sure you stay through the end credits of the movie. Not only will you see a credit for the hair tech team, which I love, but you'll also get a special scene if you stay all the way through, so don't miss that. Finally, pay attention to the rule of threes, which is in literature and also used throughout Disney, and that's the idea that things happen in threes. Here, Moana must conquer 3 challenges. It takes her 3 tries to get off of her island. Watch for other elements of three as well.
Have you seen Moana yet? What did you think of it? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And I will definitely respond. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe if you like this review so you don't miss my next one. And until next time, have a great week at the movies.